Hello everyone in medical scribe. I'm Karar Haider, student at Baghdad Medical College. In the previous video, we talked an introduction about the fascia, and we said that the fascia will be classified into four types. So today, we will look at the first type, which is the superficial fascia. This topic will be explained in two videos. In the first one, we will explain the superficial fascia, while in the second one, we will talk about the superficial fascia functions. So let's begin. The superficial fascia, which also called the subcutaneous tissue or the hypodermis, is the layer that exists directly under the skin. And it will connect between the dermis, precisely the overlying reticular dermis layer, and the underlying deep fascia. And it exists nearly in all regions of the body. Alright. Well, now we will explain a very important topic regarding this fascia, which is the structure of the superficial fascia. This superficial fascia mostly composed of loose areolar connective tissue, and it contains a large amount of adipose tissue or fats. In addition to those two major components, the connective tissue and the adipose tissue, we can find many other structures, such as the fibrous bands. These bands will anchor the skin with the deep fascia. Also, we can find the collagen and the elastin fibers. These fibers will connect the superficial fascia with the dermis layer strongly. Well, there are neurovascular structures in this fascia, which are the lymphatic vessels that connect the dermis with the lymphatic system, the nerves, which will connect the dermis and the free nerve endings of the superficial fascia with the nervous system, and the blood vessels, which will connect the dermis layer with the circulatory system. Other structures that can be found in this fascia and in specific regions of the body, such as the sweat glands and mammary glands. And we may find muscle fibers that make up a very thin muscles in this fascia, like the platysma muscle in the neck. And we can find also fibroblasts, mast cells, and macrophages. So these are the structures and the components of the superficial fascia. Now we have another thing important to know regarding this fascia. We said in the beginning of this video that the superficial fascia exists nearly in all body regions. But we didn't say that the thickness of this fascia will differ from area to other and from person to person. So, the distribution of the subcutaneous tissue will differ from one area to another in the same person. For example, in the thighs, the lower abdomen, the buttocks, and in the palm of the hand and the soles of the feet, the superficial fascia will be thicker than that of the shin, which is the anterior border of the leg, and the dorsum of the hand. Here, the superficial fascia will be thinner. And there are some structures in the body, its superficial fascia will be devoid of fats, such as the eyelids and the ear auricle. Also, the superficial fascia distribution will differ from person to person, according to the nutritional status and according to the eating food. And lastly, the superficial fascia distribution will differ between men and women. So in men, the subcutaneous tissue will accumulate mostly in the lower abdomen, while in the women, the superficial fascia will accumulate mostly in the breasts and thighs. So these were almost everything about the superficial fascia. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video, and goodbye.